Parshas Lech Lecha, Tovshinayim Ches. And this is the first week that we now get into speaking about the Avos. Avraham Avinu, Yitzchak Avinu, Yaakov Avinu. We're going to spend the next couple of months now speaking about the Avos. And of course, as you know, the lessons that we learn from the Avos and then afterwards from the Shvatim, plentiful, tremendous lessons that we learn and we analyze and we try to introduce into our own lives, just following the way the Avos led their lives is very, very inspiring to every one of us. And we begin this week's parsha by Yoimer Hashem el Avram. Hashem said to Avram, Lech lecha, me'artzecha, u'mimoladetecha, u'mibeis avicha, leave your land, your place where you were born, leave from your parents, from your father's house, el ha'aretz asher areka. Hashem is telling Avram Avinu, basically, leave everything. Drop everything you've known until now, move out, and go, head to the land that I will show you. And we know that land was Eretz Yisrael, but the Pasuk does not tell us what that land is. And the Mefarshim really speak at length, and they darshan every word of this fascinating Pasuk. Hashem just telling Avram, just go, leave, pick yourself up, like we said, leave everything. And one of the questions that is asked is on the word lecha. Lech lecha. The pasuk could have just said lech, go, but it says lech lecha. Why do we need the word lecha? So Rashi tells us that lecha means lahanoscha l'toivoscha, for your own pleasure, for your own benefit. It's going to be something for you. Go for yourself, for your own benefit. So really, the first thing we need to explain this Rashi. Why would it have to be that Avram, who loved Hashem so much, he loved Hashem more than anybody else in the world, Avram needed some kind of benefit to himself in order to go? Hashem said, go, so Avraham Avinu listens. We need lech lecha. So very nice, Rashi tells us that go for your benefit. But Avraham Avinu needs a benefit? That's one question that we ask here. So too, why would Avraham be told lech lecha, to go? Why is Avraham Avinu not told the same that Noach was told? When it was time for Noach to leave the Teva, when it was time for Noach, who had been cooped up in the Teva, to finally leave, Hashem tells Noach, say, go out of the Teva. Why wasn't Avraham Avinu told, say, mimoladetcha, me'artzecha, mimoladetcha, mibeis avicha, say, go out. Noach was told, go out. Why the difference in terminology? Another question that the Siv Shalom asks, why couldn't Avram Avinu just be told, Lech Lecha, Ela Aretz Asher Areka, go to the land which I will show you? Why does it have to be that we need to tell you where you're going out from? Lech Lecha Me'artzecha, Me'loyletecha, Me'beis Avicha, why? Lech Lecha, Ela Aretz Asher Areka. Why all the places in between? Why do we need to say all of that? So Nesiv HaShalom tells us, and he wants to explain this whole Indian, he says this is another thing that we can really point out here in our Parsha. The Pasuk tells us first, Lech Lecha Me'artzecha. And then the Pasuk says, Mimoladetecha, from your birthplace, and then Mibeis Avicha. Should it not really be the reverse? I mean, if you're thinking about how Avraham Avinu is going to go out, the first place he's going to leave is Beis Avicha. First you walk out of your house, then you walk out of your city, then you walk out of your country. Why does the Pasuk say it in the reverse order? Leave your country, leave your city, and then leave the house, your parents' house. It doesn't work that way, right? It seems, seemingly, it's in the reverse. So the kavana behind this, says the Nesiv HaShalom, is really the midos and connection that every person develops and every person has. We know, and I'm not telling you any chiddush over here, that every person is influenced by their surroundings. The places that you are, the places you grew up, the place that you live, the people you hang around with, every person is influenced by their surroundings. And that is really for good, and sometimes, unfortunately, to the contrary, for the negative. So your country and your neighborhood and your home, all three of those places, they influence you and they really make up who you are. You become a product of your neighborhood. You become a product of your family. You become a product of your country. By nature, that's just the way it is. But the closer they are to home, says the Nesiv HaShalom, the closer they are to you, the more influence they have on you. And the more influence they have on you, the more difficult it is to step out of that, to break away from that. So says the Nesiv HaShalom, Hashem came and instructed Avram Avinu, Lech Lecha, but he instructed him, Lech Lecha, in the order of how difficult it is to break free from those influences. Avraham Avinu had to leave. There was too much, there was stuff going on around him that HaKadosh Baruch Hu said, you can't stay here anymore. But obviously, it's a lot easier to leave your country than it is to leave your parents' house. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu asked Avraham to leave in the order of difficulty. Lech lecha me'artzecha. Okay, so you won't be a citizen of that country. It's difficult. You won't be a member of your city. A little more difficult. But mibeis avicha, to totally disassociate yourself from your family, that is more difficult. And therefore, the pasuk says it in the reverse order, the order that we would normally think is the way for a person to leave. So that's why Hashem told it to Avraham Avinu in that order. Beautiful, beautiful pshat. Removing a person from beis avicha and your family, that is really the toughest task before reaching El Haaretz Asher Areka. Before Avraham Avinu, before you're able to reach your destination, and the destination was a physical destination, Eretz Yisrael, but it was also the spiritual part of Eretz Yisrael. Before you reach there, you have to break free of the most difficult place to leave, and that is your family. The ultimate Dveikus Bashem in Eretz Yisrael, for that you need to totally break free. And that, says the Nesiv HaShalom, is another explanation of Lech Lecha. What Rashi says, L'hanoscho L'toivoscho, for your own pleasure and your own benefit. Because what pleased, what is Hana for Avraham Avinu? For Avraham Avinu, Hana is of course not in Yoni Olam Hazeh, in Yoni Gashmias. That's not the Hana of Avraham Avinu. What is Hana for Avraham Avinu? Like we say about Sha'oz Tis'ana Gal Hashem. It is the pleasure and the Hana of Ruchnias. The only Hana for Avraham Avinu was one of Ruchnias. So Hashem said to Avraham, L'hanoscha, you have to go out to your own Hana in order to accomplish what means the most to you, which is Dveikus Bashem, which is connecting to Hashem. For that, you need to leave all these places. L'hanoscha L'tevoscha. And we ask, what, Avraham Avinu has to hear that to some kind of Hana? No, of course it wasn't some kind of pleasure of Gashmias. Avraham Avinu was very interested in how he could connect to Hashem in the most substantial way. So L'hanoscha L'tevoscha tells us that Avraham Avinu, if you want to have the ultimate Hana and connect to Hashem and Eretz Yisrael, you need to leave from all these places. And it will be for your Hana. You will find Dveikus Bashem there. And that is why the Torah tells us also all three. Because each challenge was greater than the previous one. And each one brought Avraham Avinu closer to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and closer to where Avraham Avinu wanted to be. And we ask the question, why does the Torah tell us Lech Lecha? Why not go out as it did
by Noach. And then Siva Shalom tells us a beautiful, beautiful pshat over here. He says, you know what say means? You know what say means when you tell someone to go out? When you tell someone to leave and go out, the goal is just to have them leave. You tell someone, get out of here, leave. What's the goal? The goal is, I don't want you here anymore. I want you to leave. It doesn't really matter where that person ends up. When you need someone to leave, the object in your mind is just out of here. Where they're going to go after that, that's of no real concern. And that is what tsay means. Tsay means leave from here. Noach was told, leave the Teva. It was not very consequential where Noach would end up after that. Noach had fulfilled what he had to do. Tseiva na teva, just go out now. But here, by Avraham Avinu, it was a lot different. The main point was not believing. The main point for Avraham Avinu is where we're going to end up. What we're going to become after we leave. Avraham Avinu, the main point was El Haaretz Asher Areka. The main place was Eretz Yisrael and the Dveikus Hashem, the Dveikus Hashem that comes along with Eretz Yisrael. So when Avraham Avinu had to go out, the Pasuk says, Lech Lecha, because the going out was not a goal on its own. The Tzei was not a goal. The goal was, ultimately, yes, you're leaving, but what are you going to make of yourself? What are you going to become? Where are you going to go? Those were the main points for Avraham Avinu. So Hashem said, Lech Lecha. It's all about your destination. It's all about Avraham Avinu, how you're going to grow, where you're going to grow up. And really, when I look at this lesson, when I look at this piece of Nesivah Shalom, I see how it really teaches us a lesson for life. You know, sometimes we leave just for the sake of leaving. I can't be here anymore. I'm not comfortable. But you know, leaving is not always good enough. When you throw something behind you, and many times there are people that have been very good to you, and there are places that have been very good to you, and you just, people pick themselves up, and they just want to leave. Just leaving, a Jew doesn't behave in just leaving for the sake of leaving. Where are you going? What are you going to do after this? Do you have something better in mind? Do you have El Haaretz Asher Areka? Are you going to be better off in the place that you're going? And that's a very important thing that we always have to work out. Before you turn your back on somebody, before you turn your back on anything, remember you have to go through the entire calculation. You have to go through the whole cheshbon, the cheshbon that Hashem made before he told Avraham Avinu, El Haaretz Asher Areka, Lech Lecha. It's about the place that you're going to reach. It's not just about leaving. Sometimes leaving is easy. You know, for Noach, maybe it was a little wet out there, but the bottom line is he wanted out of that tape already, right? I mean, he wanted to begin to continue on with the world. And that's a lesson we all have to learn. You have to sometimes, you have to plan things out. You have to have a mind, you have to have a plan. How are we going to grow? Where are we going next? What is our next destination? And that is a lesson we learned very, very well from Avraham Avinu. The first lesson that we could learn from our Avos is how to leave and how to reach a destination where you could become a better person.